In this class, we are going to discuss hexadecimal addition, that will comes under hexadecimal arithmetic. Now we will see the addition rule. Whenever you are adding two hexadecimal numbers, then their sum is equivalent to decimal sum when the sum is less than 16. That means, for example, if you are adding two hexadecimal numbers, the sum is equivalent to their decimal sum if the sum is less than 16. If sum is greater than 16, then you have to subtract 16 from that sum and it will produce as a carry. So for better understanding, I am going to take an example. For example, 4 is a hexadecimal number. They take it. 4 is a hexadecimal number and 5 is also a hexadecimal number. If we are going to add these two numbers, then it will produce as 9 hexa. That means when you are adding 4 plus 5, the result is 9. So this 9 is less than 16. So that's why this is equivalent to the sum of these two hexadecimal numbers is equivalent to their decimal sum. For example, if 4 and 5 are in decimal, then the decimal sum is also equivalent to 9. So whenever two numbers are added, you have to see the sum. If the sum is less than 16, then you can write as it is. So here actually decimal sum is 9, this is less than 16. So you can write this 9 as it is as hexa sum. So for example, you are adding, this is first case. So to understand when you will produce carry, when it is going to exceed 16, means see here, I am taking A hexa plus B hexa. You know that without taking this a hexa suffix, also you know that A and B are hexadecimal numbers. If you are adding A plus B, then what is the sum, what is the decimal sum, equivalent decimal sum? A means, you know that 10, B means 11. So this is equivalent to 21. Decimal sum is equivalent to 21. So this 21 is greater than 16. In this case, you have to subtract 16 from actual decimal sum. 16 from actual decimal sum means you have to subtract 16 from actual decimal sum 21. So if you subtracted 16 from 21, you are going to get 5. So that 5 we are taking as hexadecimal sum. So 5 hexa we will take. Whatever 16 we taken out, that will overflow. That means that will comes as carry. So this sum is equivalent to 5 hexa with carry 1. So hexa, this is a hexadecimal carry. Each carry value is 16. Whatever 16 we subtracted here, that we are taking as carry. This 1 in hexadecimal represents carry value 16. So it, like that, for example, third case, if you are adding 5 hexa plus 9 hexa, like this if you are adding, then what is its sum? So see here, 5 plus 9. So 5 plus 9 means 14. So actual decimal sum is 14. 14 is less than 16. So whenever the actual sum is less than 16, then you can write as it is. That means 5 plus 9 is equal to 14. 14 hexa. 14 hexa you can't write in hexadecimal. So that's why you are decoding like E hexa. So already told you in the last classes that why we can't write 14 hexa means, for example, anyone new person came here and he is reading 14 hexa, that is different. That means he is taking like place value 1 and place value 0 and place value 1, like that he is taking like two separate numbers, like 1 and 4 as two separate numbers, that he may fully understand this. This is not a single digit hexadecimal number. He may feel like this is a two digit hexadecimal number with two digits 14. To take out that confusion, I taken this 14 as E. Definitely you can't write 14 hexa like this. You have to write E hexa when you got the sum 14. So like this you can add any two numbers. So for better understanding, I am taking some examples like add 5, we have 6, 4, 2, 8, 3, 7, like this. I am taking these two hexadecimal numbers to add. For example, see here, what is the value here means 7 plus 4. 7 plus 4 means, so this is equivalent to 11. 11 means B. So 11 is always less than 16. So no need of subtracting 16, you can take as it is. So you can take as it is means you can take B here. So this is equivalent to B now. Now 6 plus 3, 6 plus 3 is 9. This is also less than 16, you can take as it is. Now see here, this is F means 15, 15 plus 8, 15 plus 8 means this is equivalent to some 23. So 23 is greater than 16. So whenever two digit sum exceeds 16, what we have to do in hexadecimal arithmetic addition? So you need to subtract that 16 from that sum. So you are going to get, so some 7 you are getting. So you need to take 7 with carry 1 you need to take. Whatever 16 you subtracted here, that you need to take as carry and overflow. And here the sum is equivalent to subtraction of actual sum minus 16. So F plus 8 will result 7 with carry 1. So now finally 1 plus 5 plus 2. So nothing but 8. So that the hexadecimal sum of these two hexadecimal number will result 8790 hexa. In the same way we can add 4 numbers or 5 numbers or 6 numbers or n numbers we can add. Let us take another example like 5FA and 3B2 and 61F. I taken 3 numbers, I taken 3 hexadecimal numbers. Now I used to get some addition result by with this 3 numbers. So I am taking A. A means 10. 10 plus 2, 12. So 12 plus 15, F means 15. Totally this is equivalent to 27. 27 is greater than 16 now. We can't take 27 here. There is no representation for 27 in hexadecimal. That is the reason why I am taking 27 minus 16. So here you need to take 27 minus 16. So now whenever you are taking out 16, the remaining is 11. 11 means B. So B with carry 1 will result. So whatever 16 we are taking out, that we are taking as 1. The remaining thing is 11. 11 means B. So B with carry 1 is here addition result. Now we will see this column. F means 15. 15 plus 1 16. 16 plus B means 11. 16 plus B 11 means 27. This is up to 27. 27 plus 1, 28 here. So 28 means 28 is also greater than 16. Now again in this column also you need to take 28 minus 16 here. So this is equivalent to 12. 12 means C. So C with carry 1, whatever 16 you subtracted from actual sum, that you need to take as carry. So you take in the carry and now the term is for this column. So now I am adding this column. 1 plus 5, 6. 6 plus 3, it's equivalent to 9. 9 plus 6 is equivalent to 15. 15 in hexadecimal we can represent and 15 is less than 16. Directly we can decode that 15 as F. Now by adding these 3 hexadecimal numbers, we are getting FCB as resultant addition result of particular addition. So in the same way we can add n numbers, n hexadecimal numbers, and we can get the result easily. The only thing you have to keep in mind is when you are adding two digits of hexadecimal, after completion of that addition you have to see the sum. If the sum is less than 16, you can take as it is. For example, sum is from 10 to 15, you can take A, B, C, D, E, F. For example, if it exceeds 16, in some cases, you may get the sum as 16. For example, if the sum is 16, 16 also you are not going to represent. So, 16 is not less than 16, 16 is equal to 16. In this case also, you need to take 16 minus 16, 0 with carry 1. So, that means anywhere you got like this, F plus 1. If you are adding F plus 1, F means 15, 1 means 1. So, 15 plus 1 means 16. So, you need to get the addition result means 16 you can't represent. So, 16 minus 16 you are going to take. So, the result is 0 with carry 1. That carry you will take here. So, in the same way we can find any hexadecimal addition.